गुड आफ्टरनून ऑल, वेलकम टू द लेक्चर ऑफ नंबर थ्योरी। एम ऑडिबल? ओके, सो इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव सीन व्हाट इज द एलसीएम। सो लेट अस डिफाइन व्हाट इज द एलसीएम, व्हाट इज मीन बाय लीस्ट कॉमन मल्टीपल। यस, least common multiple.
अशी संख्या ज्याला दोन्ही बी संख्येने भाग जातो
तशी संख्या खूप मिळतील। फॉर एक्झाम्पल 2 अँड 3 आर द टू इंटीजर्स, एनी मल्टिपल ऑफ 2 अँड 3 इज एनी मल्टिपल ऑफ 2 अँड 3
इज सर्वात लहान
बाय बोथ
सर्वात लहान
That one is least. Okay, so here we have to find out the integer m, which is the multiple of a and b, and it is least among all the multiples of a and b. Okay, that one is nothing but the least common multiple. Okay, now today we have to prove one result. That one is nothing but the least common multiple is unique. It means we have to show that if we have a and b are any two non-zero integer, then having least common multiple is unique. Okay. And in a GCD, if we have to find out the GCD of two integers a and b, then we require at least one of them will be non-zero. But in LCM, we require both the integers are non-zero, then we can find out the LCM of that two integers. For example, if a and b are two any integers and a will be equal to zero, then always b will, and b is non-zero, then b will be always a least common multiple of that two integers a and b. So for that reason only we have to choose a and b both are non-zero. Okay. So now the next theorem, that one is nothing but the least common multiple. Common multiple is unique. Okay. So for any two non-zero integers, the least common multiple will be unique. So let us see the proof of this theorem. Let a and b are any two non-zero integers. Okay, and here we have to show that the least common multiple of this a and b is unique, and we have to show that LCM of these two integers a and b is unique. As we have to show that the LCM of a and b is unique, here we will assume that the integers a and b has more than two LCM. Here we will take the integers a and b has two LCMs. So let us assume that m and m dash are the two LCMs of A and B. Okay, so here we have taken M and M dash are the two least common multiples of A and B. Now we know the definition of LCM. First one is nothing but if A and B are any two non-zero integers, then any M is said to be a least common multiple of A and B. If it is a multiple of A and B and it is a least among all the multiples, that is A divides M and B divides M is the first condition, and second condition is nothing but if N is another integer which is divisible by both the integers A and B, then M is less equal by N or equivalent to M divides N. As here, in first case, we will assume that first case. Assume M is a least common multiple. As here we have two least common multiples m and m dash. In first case, we will take m is a least common multiple. As m is a least common multiple, m dash is also a multiple of a and b. Then, what is the relation between m and m dash? A and b are any two non-zero integers having LCM is m for first case. And m dash is also a multiple of a and b. Then what is the relation between these two multiples of a and b? this m must be less equal by m dash or m divides m dash. Okay, and in second case, if we take let m dash is a LCM. If m dash is a least common multiple of a and b, then what is the relation between m dash and m? M dash is less equal by m, or equivalently m dash divides m. As m and m dash both are the positive integers such that m divides m dash and m dash divides m, then what is the relation between m and m dash? दोन पॉझिटिव्ह इंटीजर सांगा जे असे असतील, ए डिवाइड्स बी करतो आणखी बी डिवाइड्स ए करतो. ए अँड बी डिस्टिंक्ट असू शकतील का? आर एम इज लेस इक्वल बाय एम डॅश अँड एम डॅश इज लेस इक्वल बाय एम, देन बाय द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ इज लेस इक्वल, व्हाट इज द रिलेशन बिटवीन एम अँड एम डॅश? आवाज येते ना माझं का कळत नाही तुम्हाला काहीच? जर तुम्ही असं शांत बसणार असेल तर मी पण सिलेबस घेऊन पळवून संपून टाकेल बघा. तुम्हाला जर ही प्रॉपर्टी माहित नसतील तर काय अर्थ आहे का याला? दोन पॉझिटिव्ह इंटीजर असतील, एक दुसऱ्याला डिवाइड करतो, दुसरा परत पहिल्याला डिवाइड करतो, तर या दोन इंटीजर मध्ये काय रिलेशन असेल? एकच पॉसिबिलिटी आहे ना, असं शक्य आहे का कधी? हा यालाही डिवाइड करतो, हा यालाही डिवाइड करतो आणि दोन्ही वेगवेगळे डिस्टिंक्ट आहेत. पॉझिटिव्ह इंटीजर्स साठी कधीच मिळणार नाही. इफ इन केस वी विल टेक द सेट ऑफ इंटीजर्स, देन इट इज पॉसिबल टू डिवाइड्स मायनस टू अँड मायनस टू डिवाइड्स टू. बट ऑलरेडी आय हॅव टोल्ड यू दॅट एज ए अँड बी आर एनी टू नॉन झिरो इंटीजर्स, देन द लिस्ट कॉमन मल्टिपल मस्ट बी अ पॉझिटिव्ह इंटीजर. एज वी हॅव टेकन एम अँड एम डॅश आर द टू पॉझिटिव्ह इंटीजर्स, देन एम डिवाइड्स एम डॅश अँड एम डॅश डिवाइड्स एम, देन इट इम्प्लाइज दॅट एम मस्ट बी इक्वल टू एम डॅश ओनली. Okay, so here, if we take m and m dash are the two least common multiples of a and b, then here we will get m is equal to m dash, and that from that one we will conclude that the least common multiple must be unique. जरी तुम्ही दोन वेगळे आहेत असं समजून जरी घेतलं तरी ते दोन वेगळे असलेले इथे आपल्याला इक्वल आले, त्यामुळे द लिस्ट कॉमन मल्टिपल इज ऑलवेज युनिक. ओके, now next there is one result. If a and b are two positive integers then gcd of a and b into LCM of A and B is equal to A into B. Okay, as I have already told you that the GCD of AB is also denoted by the symbol ordered pair AB, and similarly LCM of A and B is denoted by the square bracket A and B. Okay, so this ordered pair is nothing but the GCD of A and B, GCD, and this square bracket is nothing but the LCM of two integers A and B. And we have to show that the product of GCD and LCM is nothing but the product of the two integers A and B. Let us see the proof now. Let A and B be two positive integers. Already we have given that A and B are any two positive integers. Okay, so let us. D is the GCD of integers a and b. So here we have taken d is nothing but the gcd of ab and small m is nothing but the lcm of two integers a and b. And we have to show that gcd of ab into lcm of ab is nothing but a into b, but gcd of ab is d, lcm of ab is m, and which is equal to a into b. That is we have to do. Let us take this one as some star. Okay, so as d is the gcd of two integers a and b, it implies that d divides a and d divides b. Since d is the greatest common divisor of both the integers a and b, which implies there exist integers. As here now, here we have to apply the definition of divisibility. As d divides a, then a is nothing but d into some integer q, which implies there exist integers x and y such that a is nothing but d into x and b is nothing but d into some y. And let us take this one as some equation number one. But as d is the GCD of AB and x and y are any two integers such that a equal to dx and b is equal to dy, then this x and y are always relatively prime. So as GCD of x and y is equal to 1 and d is the GCD of two integers a and b, then d can be expressed as a linear combination of this x and y, that is a and b. So d is equal to ax plus by. And also here, m is the LCM of two integers a and b. Okay, so as m is the LCM of a b, then which implies a divides m and b divides m. Again, we have to apply the definition of divisibility. Then there exist integers q1 and q2 such that m is nothing but a into q1, and in second case m is nothing but b into some q2. Let us take this one as some equation number 2. Okay, now as we know that d is the linear combination of two integers a and b, that is m ax plus by. Now just multiply both sides by m. As m is non-zero integer, then we can easily multiply. So it is nothing but m into ax plus m into by. Now we have to put the value of m here. In this case, here we will put the value of m as b into q2 ax plus a into q1 by. That is, it can be written as a into b is common in both the terms, then here we will take a b common, then it is nothing but q2x plus q1 of y, and this one is nothing but m into d. As now here m into d is multiple of this a into b, then by the definition of divisibility, a into b must divides this m d. And let us take this one as some equation number 3. Okay, so here we will get a relation between a b and m d is a into b divides m d. As here a and b are any two positive integers, m is positive, d is positive, then all this a b is positive, m d is also positive. Further, consider a b upon d is equal to, what is the value of a? A is nothing but dx and b is nothing but dy. Here a is dx and b is dy. Then from equation number 1, a is nothing but b into x, b as it is divided by d. This d, this d gets cancelled, which is equal to b into x. Similarly, again a b upon d is equal to, here we have put the value of a. Now put the value of b, a into by, sorry, dy divided by d. Again d get cancelled and it is nothing but a into y. Now which implies that, as we know that b divides a b divided by d. Okay, so actually it is nothing but b into a divided by d. That is, as b divides b, then it divides any multiple of b. So b divides a b upon d. Okay, and also a divides a b upon d. So here we get a b divides a b upon d and a divides a b upon d, which implies a into b divided by d is a common multiple of a and b. Common multiple of two integers a and b. Okay, now as LCM of a b is m, as LCM of two integers AB is M. Okay, now here AB upon D is a common multiple of A and B, but LCM of AB is M, then what is the relation between M and AB upon D?
Yes.
What is the relation between these two integers? A b upon d is a common multiple of a and b, and m is the LCM of a and b. As m is the least common multiple of a and b, and a b upon d is a common multiple, then m divides ab upon d or ab upon d divides m. What is the second condition of definition of LCM? If m is a LCM and n is any common multiple, then that m must divide at n or m is less equal by n. As here ab upon d is a common multiple of a and b, LCM of ab is m, then what is the relation between m and ab upon d?
M divides ab upon
d. M divides ab upon d. But as we know that d is any non-zero integer, since d is the GCD of ab, it means it must be positive only, which implies multiply both, that is numerator and denominator, by d, then we get m into d divides ab upon d into d, which is a into b. So let us take this one as some equation number 4. Now let us see equation 3 and 4. Equation 3 is nothing but ab divides m into d. Equation 4 is nothing but m into divides a and b. M into d and a and b, both are the positive integers. Ab divides md, md divides ab. What is the relation between ab and md?
Md equal to ab.
Md is nothing but a into b. But what is m? M is nothing but LCM, b is nothing but GCD. So which implies that GCD of ab into LCM of ab is equal to a into. And that is we have to put, hence the proof. Yes, yamadhye konal kahi doubt astil tar vichar. आहे का कोणाला डाउट?
नो सर.
ओके, नाउ लेट अस सी द नेक्स्ट वन. देन देयर इज वन कोरोलरी डिपेंडिंग ऑन दिस रिजल्ट. इफ ए एंड बी आर, इफ स्मॉल ए एंड बी आर पॉजिटिव इंटीजर्स, देन LCM of A into B is equal to, sorry, LCM of AB is equal to A into B if GCD of AB equal to 1. That is we have to prove. Okay, so here we have to prove that whenever GCD of AB will be equal to 1, then we have to show that LCM of AB is nothing but A into B. Okay, so see this proof there. By above theorem, GCD of A and B into LCM of AB, sorry, LCM of AB is equal to A into B. But here we have given that GCD of AB equal to 1. But here GCD of A and B is equal to 1. Then the star becomes. One into LCM of AB is equal to A into B. That is, least common multiple of A and B is equal to A into B. That one is nothing but square bracket AB, that is LCM of AB is A into B, and that is we have to show. And hence the. Okay, this is for any two positive integers A and B. Instead of 2, if suppose we have n pairwise prime integers, that is a1, a2, a2, so on, an or any n prime integers. Let us take corollary 2. Okay. If a1, a2, up to so on, an, all are pairwise prime integers, then LCM of a1, a2 up to so on an is nothing but product of all these integers a1, a2 up to so on an, which is just by the above corollary solution. Same as corollary. corollary one. Since, as we know that, what is the relation between GCD and LCM and product of two integers AB? GCD of AB into LCM of AB is nothing but the product of two integers A and B. As A and B are any two positive integers. Instead of two, we have three integers A, B, C. Then GCD of ABC into LCM of ABC is equal to A into B into C. Similarly, which is true for these n integers also. That is GCD of A1, A2 up to so on AN into LCM of A1, A2 up to so on AN is equal to A1 into A2 into A3 into up to so on AN. But here we have given all the integers, that is all these n integers are pairwise prime. It means if we choose any one two integers among these n integers, that is AI and AJ, then having GCD will be 1. It implies that GCD of A1, A2 up to so on AN is also 1. But again, by we know the result, GCD of A1, A2 up to so on AN into LCM of A1, A2 up to so on AN is equal to A1 into A2 into A3 into up to so on AN. But GCD of all these n integers will be equal to 1. So LCM of A1, A2 up to so on AN is nothing but A1 into A2 into A3 into up to so on AN. And that is we have to put. Okay. Yes, up to now, any doubt? अपरेंट कुणाल काही डाउट आहे
सर.
नेक्स्ट अगेन देयर इज वन थ्योरम. इफ एलसीएम ऑफ ए1 एंड ए2 इज सम m2, एलसीएम ऑफ m2 एंड ए3 इज सम m3, एंड अप टू सो ऑन LCM of MN minus 1 comma AN is equal to some MN, then LCM of A1, A2 up to so on AN is equal to MN. That is we have to put. Okay, so here we have given that A1, A2 up to so on AN are any N integers, and M2, M3 up to so on MN are any N minus 1 integers. Okay, so here also given that LCM of A1, A2 is M2, LCM of this M2 and A3 is M3, up to so on, LCM of MN minus 1 and AN is MN, then we have to show that LCM of A1, A2 up to so on AN is nothing but MN only. Okay, so let us see the proof. As we have LCM of MN minus 1 and AN is MN. The least common multiple of MN minus 1 and AN is MN. Then by the definition of least common multiple, MN minus 1 divides MN and AN also divides MN minus 1. Sorry. AN divides MN. Since MN is a least common multiple, let's take this one as question number 1. Similarly, LCM of MN minus 2 comma AN minus 1 previous of this step is nothing but MN minus 1. Now as MN minus 1 is the least common multiple of these two integers, then MN minus 2 divides a MN minus 1 and AN minus 1 divides MN minus 1. But by equation 1, MN minus 2 divides MN minus 1, MN minus 1 divides MN, then by the transitivity, MN minus 2 divides MN, MN minus 2 divides MN, and also AN minus 1 divides MN minus 1, MN minus 1 divides MN, it means AN minus 1 divides MN. Take this equation number 2, and it is from equation number 1. Okay, so here MN minus 2 divides MN and AN minus 1 divides MN. Similarly, AN also divides MN, which is from equation 1. Continuing in this way, we can get A1, A2 up to so on AN, all the integers divides MN. Continuing this process, we can show that AN, AN minus 1 up to so on A2, A1 all divides N, MN, all divides MN. Okay, actually first let us see what is we have to do. LCM of A1, A2 up to so on AN is MN. Then by the definition of LCM, m n is said to be a LCM of these n integers whenever all these integers a1, a2, up to so on, an divides m n, and m n, it means m n is a common multiple of these n integers, and we have to show that in second condition it is a list among all the multiples. Okay, so here a1, a2, up to so on, an all divides m n, so it shows the first condition of LCM. It shows the first condition of definition of least common multiple. Okay, now it remains to prove the second one. The second one, we will take one another common multiple of a1, a2, up to so on, an. So let a1, a2, up to so on, an all divides an integer C. Okay, now as we know that LCM of a1 and a2, that is by given, is nothing but m2. Okay, LCM of a1 and a2 is m2, and a1, a2, up to so on, an all divides an integer C. It means a1, a2 also divides C, which implies that C is a common multiple of a1 and a2 also. So here C is one common multiple of a1 and a2, and LCM of a1 and a2 is m2, then what is the relation between m2 and C? Yes, a common multiple ankhin least common multiple madhe dogan madhe kay sambandh asto? Least common multiple ha lahan asto common multiple peksha, ta common multiple ha lahan asto least common multiple. Yes,
LCM lahan asto common multiple.
Yes, as M2 is a least common multiple and C is a multiple, it implies that M2 divides C. As A1, A2 divides C, then M2 also divides C. Okay, now also LCM of M2 and A3 is nothing but M3. As we know that A3 divides, we know that A3 divides C, and here we have proven that M2 also divides C. So we know that M2 and A3 divides C. As M2 and A3 divides C, and M3 is the least common multiple of M2 and A3, then M3 must divides C. Also, M3 divides C. Okay. Continuing in this way, we can show that Mn also divides C. Since here we have, in first step we have proved that M2 divides C, in second one we have proved that M3 divides C, in third one we will prove M4 divides C, and continuing in this way we can show that Mn minus 1 divides C, and also Mn also divides C. So Mn also divides an integer C. Okay, thus Mn satisfies condition 2 of definition of LCM. Okay, as it satisfies both the conditions, then LCM of a1, a2, up to so on, an is nothing but Mn, and hence LCM of a1, a2, up to so on, an is nothing but Mn. And that is we have to, and hence the required. Yes, your result madhe kunal kahi doubt? Yes, no, काही तरी सांगा.
नो सर।
ओके नाउ देयर इज वन एग्जांपल शो दैट द डिफरेंस ऑफ two consecutive cube is never divisible by an integer two. Okay, so here we have to show that the difference of two consecutive cube is never divisible by. See the solution. Let a and a plus 1 are any two consecutive integers. Consecutive integers. Let us consider its, that is, difference of its cubes. So consider a plus 1 cube minus a cube. What is a plus 1 cube? What is its value? A plus b bracket cube, a cube plus 3a square b, b is 1 plus 3ab square b is 1 plus 1 cube is 1 minus of a cube plus a cube minus a cube get cancelled. So it is nothing but 3 into a square plus 3a plus 1, which is nothing but 3 into a square plus a, that is 3a common. Let us take 3a common, then it is nothing but 3 into a plus 1. And plus 1. Okay, now tell me whether this integer is always divisible by 2, 3 into a plus 1 plus 1. This one is always an odd integer.
Yes, sir.
So 3 into a plus 1 is not in the form of, not in the form of multiple of 2, that is 2 into some k. Since any integer is divisible by 2 if it is multiple of 2. As this one is not a multiple of 2, not in the form of multiple of 2, so this, that integer, that is 3 into a plus 1 plus 1 is not divisible by 2. Therefore, the difference of two consecutive cube is never divisible by integer. Next example. Prove that for a given positive integer n, GCD of a and a plus n divides an integer n. Okay, so here we have to show that GCD of a and a plus n divides an integer. Okay, let consider D is nothing but the GCD of A and A plus N. As D is the GCD of A and A plus N, then what is the relation between D and A? D divides A and D divides A plus N. And we know the property of divisibility. As a and a plus n are the any two integers which is divisible by d, then this d divides any multiple of a and a plus n, which implies d divides a into x plus a plus n into y, where x and y are any two integers, that is, they are belonging to set of integers. Now this is true for any x y belonging to z. So here we will take the value of a x as 1 and value of y as minus 1. Then we get divides a plus a plus n into minus of 1. So it is nothing but d divides a plus minus a minus of n. This minus a plus a get cancelled. So which implies d divides minus n. And we know that as d divides minus n, then d must divides n also. Okay. So here we get d divides n, which implies that GCD of a and a plus n must divides an integer n. And hence the proof, that is we have to show. Okay. सो हियर इथं जर कोणाला प्रॉब्लेम असेल डी डिवाइड्स मायनस एन वरून डी डिवाइड्स एन तर दुसरी अरेंजमेंट करू शकता इन्स्टेड ऑफ कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ ए विल बी टेकन एज वाय अँड कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ एक्स सॉरी ए प्लस एन विल बी टेकन एज एक्स देन वी गेट दॅट इज इन्स्टेड ऑफ दिस वन इट वी टेक डी डिवाइड्स ए प्लस एन इन टू एक्स प्लस ay. Now here we will choose the value of x as 1 and value of y as minus 1. Then we get d divides a plus n into 1 minus of a. Minus a plus a get cancelled and directly we will get d divides a. Okay. So in this way we can show that GCD of a and a plus n must divides an integer. Okay. Next example. Assuming that GCD of A and B is equal to 1. Prove that GCD of A plus B and A minus B is equal to either 1 or 2. Prove this one. येस काय करावं लागेल गिवन दॅट जीसीडी ऑफ ए बी विल बी इक्वल टू वन अँड वी हॅव टू प्रूव्ह दॅट जीसीडी ऑफ ए प्लस बी कॉमा ए मायनस बी इज आयदर वन ऑर टू हाऊ कॅन वी शो कसं दाखवू शकतो याला आपण
वन डिवाइड एक्स प्लस बी वाय आणि एक्स आणि वायची व्हॅल्यू घेत
कसं घेईल Let suppose that d is nothing but the gcd of these two integers a plus b and a minus b. D is nothing but the gcd of a plus b and a minus b, and using gcd of ab will be equal to 1, we have to show that this d is either 1 or 2. Okay, now as d is the gcd of a plus b and a minus b, which implies d divides a plus b and d divides a minus b also. Again, we know that if d divides a and d divides b, then d divides any linear combination of a and b, which implies d divides a plus b plus a minus b, and also d divides a plus b minus of a minus b, which implies d divides a plus b a minus b plus b get cancelled, it divides 2a, and d divides plus a minus a get cancelled, b minus of minus b, which is 2b. So here d divides 2a and d divides 2b. Okay, let us take this one as some equation number one. As given that GCD of AB is equal to an integer 1, which implies there exist integers x and y such that this one can be written as a linear combination of A and B, which is by the property of GCD. So 1 is nothing but AX plus BY. Now, which implies that as D divides 2A and D divides 2B, then D divides any linear combination of 2A and 2B. It means D divides 2A into some X plus 2 into B into some Y. Since it divides the any linear combination of 2A and 2B, which implies D divides. Let us take 2A, 2 common. Then it divides AX plus BY, which implies D divides. What is the value of AX plus BY from this equation number 2? Which one. Is 1. So D divides one. 2. Now, as D is any positive integer which it divides 2, then what are the possible values of D?
1.
D is a GCD. As D is a GCD, then it must be greater than 0. So, and D divides 2, then what are the possible values of D?
1 or 2.
1 or 2. Since 1 and 2 are the only two integers which divides an integer 2. That is positive non-zero. 1 and 2 are the only two non-zero positive integers which divides 2. And hence D is equal to either 1 or 2. But D is nothing but GCD of A plus B, comma A minus B, and which is equal to either 1 or 2. And that is how to show. Next, again there is one example. If A and B are two positive integer then an ordered pair A plus B, an integer A plus B into LCM of A and B is equal to B into LCM of A and A plus B. Okay, so here we have given A and B are the any two positive integers, and from that one we have to prove that A plus B into LCM of AB is nothing but B into LCM of A and A plus B. Proof. Consider the RHS. Consider RHS. What is RHS? That is right hand side. B into LCM of A and A plus B. As we know that GCD of AB into LCM of AB is nothing but A into B. As this one is the LCM of A in comma A plus B, then what is this value? Which is nothing but A into A plus B divided by GCD of A and A plus B. So it is nothing but B into A into A plus B divided by GCD of A and A plus B, which is by the result this one. GCD of AB into LCM of AB is equal to LCM of AB is nothing but A into B. So what is LCM? LCM is nothing but A into B divided by GCD of AB. So here we have taken A into A plus B divided by GCD of A and A plus B. So which is equal to A into B into A plus B divided by A comma, GCD of A and A plus B. Okay, so which is equal to, we can write this one as A plus B into AB divided by, as from this one, GCD of A and A plus N must divides an integer N. Again, there is one result. GCD of A plus A comma A plus N also equal to GCD of AN. Okay. So as GCD of A comma A plus N is nothing but the GCD of AN, then by this one, GCD of A comma A plus B is nothing but the GCD of AB. So it is nothing but GCD of AB. Since GCD of A comma A plus N is nothing but the GCD of A and N. So which is equal to A plus B. Now we know the definition of, property this one. BCD of AB into LCM of AB is equal to AB, then AB upon BCD of AB is nothing but the LCM of AB. So this one is A into B and divided by BCD of AB is nothing but the LCM of A and B. And I think that one is nothing but the right left hand side of this equation. So which is nothing but LHS, which implies that A plus B into LCM of AB is nothing but B into LCM of A comma A plus B, and hence the proof. Yes. या रिजल्ट मध्ये कोणाला काही डाउट असतील तर विचार. आहे का कोणाला काही डाउट?
नो सर.
Now, here are some properties for integers a, b, c, d. A, b, c, and d. We have some properties. If a divides b, then a divides b into c also. Second one. If a divides b and a divides c, then a square divides b into c. And the third one, a divides b if and only if a into c divides b into c for any c not equal to 0. And the last one is nothing but a divides b and c divides d if and that is then a into c must divides b into d. Okay, so these are the four properties for any two four integers a, b, c, d. Okay, I think here there is no need to give the proof of this property, since whenever a divides b, then a divides any multiple of b also. So first one is proved. Okay, since whenever a divides b, then obviously it divides the any multiple of b, so a divides b into c also. Okay, now second one, if a divides b and a divides c, then a square must divides bc. Okay, as a divides b, a divides c, then whatever will be the value of a into a, that is a square, it must divides b into c also, which is just by the definite properties of divisibility. So second one is also easy to prove. If we want to prove, then we can prove. Okay, but these are the some simple properties, so there is no need to define this one. Now, as a divides b, then we have to show that ac divides bc whenever c is not equal to 0. Whenever a divides b, then if we multiply the numerator and denominator by c, which is not equal to 0, then there is no effect on its value. Okay, since c is any non-zero integer, and here we have to define the numerator and denominator by that integer c, so obviously that c get cancelled. So we get the value a divides b. So whenever a divides b, then a must ac must divides bc for any c not equal to 0. So third one is also proved, and the last one. A never a divides b and c divides b, then we have to show that ac divides bd. Okay, so as here a divides b, which implies there exists integer sum q1 such that b is nothing but sum a into q1, and also c divides d, which implies there exists an integer sum q2 such that d is equal to c into q2. Okay, and we have to show that this ac must divides bd. So consider the multiplication of these two. So b into d is nothing but a into c into q1 into q2. That can be written as ac into q1 q2. As b into d is a multiple of this ac, which implies ac must divides bd, and hence the proof. Okay, so in this way we can prove the these four properties. Yes. तपर्यंत कुणाला काही डाऊट असतील तर विचारू शकता.